Yeah, what a season it's been. And Tony Goldsmith survived two ejections in a row. But last night, there was only a mysterious glass jar of cow's eyes standing between her time in the jungle and the ultimate ejection.
Got your number?
Yep.
For the celebrity leaving the jungle is...
Absolutely loved her on the show. Actress, singer and TV presenter Tody Goldsmith joins us now live. Tody, it's such a pleasure to speak to you. You get the shakes watching that again.
Such a pleasure to speak to you. I'm just recovering from seeing
how high
I flew.
That's it. You managed, Tody, to escape two of those ejections. I guess your luck was just up last night.
Yeah, no, do you know what? To be honest, I was ready to leave. I was exhausted and I needed food so badly. And I think absolutely perfect how it panned out.
Well, you say that you were happy to go. What was the worst part of it? Because last year I was talking to Grant Denyer and the one thing that he couldn't handle, I'm not sure whether or not this has come out yet, I'm sure he won't mind me saying
it, now.
Is that when he was on the drop toilet, there'd always be flies that would hit his bum. And after everything Grant Denyer's been through, that was enough for him. Did you have flies hitting you on your bottom?
Look, yes. I'm pretty rugged. I'm pretty tough. That didn't bother me as much. To be honest, and I have not talked about this before, but I was getting migraines because I'm prone to them and the lack of food was triggering them and I was having them every day. Oh. And by the end, I was getting two migraines a day and I was just like, I really need to go home and eat and get on top of the migraines. So that was the worst part for me. It wasn't the flies on my bum, which now we understand cows and sheep feel, but it was more about my health.
Well, you did open up during your time in the jungle and for the first time, you shared how you were caught up in a drug scandal. Just how much did that event impact your life and did it feel good to share it with the camp, honey?
Yeah, it affected my life in a huge way. Mm. All my work fell away, but it was actually worse. The worst part was seeing the impact on my dad. He died a year ago, so I'm a bit sensitive about that still. But I couldn't defend myself, he couldn't defend me, and just seeing the impact on him and my daughter was actually worse than anything. And did it feel good talking to the campmates? It did. I was actually triggered because Davina had been talking about not being supported by the press at the time she went through, which really triggered me. And, you know, suddenly it's coming out. But what was great about talking about it was, you know, it was cathartic. I was raised in an era, you know, I was born in 1962, where, you know, women are seen and not heard. And I wasn't raised to have a voice and stand up for myself. And the young women of today are so in their power. And the Me Too movement have been such an extraordinary thing. I'm learning so much from these people. Yeah. And, you know, you could say, well, that happened 11 years ago. But the things, that was trauma for me. Trauma stays in your body. And getting it out is really cathartic. And so I'm really glad I talked about it. For my sake and my dad's sake and my daughter's sake, but really to stand in my power as a woman.
Yeah.
And it's really great to hear. We just talked before about the dynamic of this particular group. You go in there, you're obviously going in, you're going to meet some people who you haven't met before. We could pick anyone that you've built a relationship with, but you seem to form a really beautiful friendship with Brooke. In there. What is it about Brooke that you love? I mean, do you think both being musicians might have drawn you together?
I don't think it was that. I think she didn't know who I was. I didn't know who she was. And the minute I walked in, we just like magnets to each other. And I think it's something about our sense of humour and warmth. We really triggered each other's sense of humour. We cuddled all the time. We got the giggles on such a profound level and she's very playful and I'm very playful. I'm the same age as her mother. So, you know, it's beautiful how that is all ages all stripped away, but it's the way you connect with someone. And we triggered each other and we both can't remember anything. We both were laughing that we don't have a memory. We're going, what was that again? And we just, we just laughed a lot, and it was a very intimate, close bond. But that started happening with other people. Brooks was immediate, and then other people open up slower. But she's such a beautiful, open person, and I'm really open too. We're both sort of unguarded in that way, and I think that's what brought us together.
Oh,
so quickly. And she designed my headband. You didn't see it, but she went, right, I'm your stylist, and she made the headband. And then we're having this gag about that, you know, people can tell us apart, we're identical. So we had a lot of fun with everything, and she's just, yeah, she's a legend.
Oh, friends for life. And you also shared with Brooke that Olivia Newton-John is in fact your auntie. Is it true Olivia is one of your biggest supporters?
Yeah, it is. I mean, Olivia really stepped up. She was more of a mother to me than anything. And, I mean, she's just my auntie. And I think I was talking about her being my auntie, but she's always been a supporter. Even through that drug thing, she had my back like I can't tell you, because she's used to being, sadly, I mean, she's just the most beautiful human being. I can't imagine people ever cruel to her, but she's experienced it as well. So, you know, she was amazing to me, and she is amazing. And I just couldn't believe that Brooke had actually written a song that she recorded all those years ago. The 6 degrees of separation never ceases to amaze me. And that blew me away. As much as Brooke was blown away that Olivia was my aunt, I think I was more blown away that she wrote a song that Olivia sang.
So, oh, wow. It definitely runs in the family, because you are fantastic.
Toddy, fans have written in some questions for you to answer. Are you ready to answer them for us, babe?
Couldn't be more ready.
Okay. Well, the first one comes from Angie. Angie says, hi, Toddy Goldsmith. I love it when they say your first and last name, don't you? Hi, Toddy Goldsmith. My question is, any chance of a reunion with the other ladies of the Shantuzies and maybe some new music?
Hey, Angie, thank you so much for your question. At the moment, I've hung up my stilettos, but that doesn't mean to say that if there was like a great charity event or something really big that the girls wanted me to jump in, I wouldn't jump in. But there's other things I really wanted to focus on, and, you know, I've had trouble with my voice. So for me, my stilettos are still hanging up there. But thank you so much for your question.
Still there, but you didn't shout them out, so it could happen, yeah. Luke's question, Toddy, is what are your memories doing Prisoner?
Wow, that was a long, long time ago. It was interesting because I was really young. It was my second ever television job. My first one was Young Doctors. And I was so raw, so green, so young, and I walked into this world of these women that were just extraordinary and powerful, and I was really scared. I was a bit intimidated by them. But I had the most amazing experience because I got thrown into something that I was a little out of my league at the time, but a really amazing experience. But it was really my biggest memory is that I couldn't believe I was on the show, really.
Well, you certainly deserve to be there. Carly wrote to you, what was the first thing you did after leaving the jungle?
Carly, the first thing I did after leaving the jungle was I called my daughter. I just could not wait to hear her voice. And then I just couldn't stop eating. It was like, get away from my food. It was like a wild beast with a carcass. I was so hungry. I dropped 3.5 kilos in a very short period of time, and I'm not a big person. I was just starving. So that was it. I called Layla and I ate.
Good on you. Toddy, another one here from Mike. Mike wants to know, Toddy, I saw you caught COVID last year. Hope you're okay now. How long did it take you to recover?
Thanks for your question. I was one of those unlucky ones that it did hang around for quite a while. I got hit quite heavily with it. And after I started feeling better, I would, you know, take a little bit of a walk, and then I'd be hit down for another 3 days, and I was getting shocking headaches and really heavy fatigue, probably 6 weeks all up. So it wasn't a quick one for me, but it's all gone now and I feel amazing. But I really understand, I'm very empathetic to those people that got hit hard with it, and you know, I get it. And a whole lot of people, you know, had different symptoms. A girlfriend of mine got severe nausea, and another one, you know, they got different things. But for me, it was really bad headaches and really bad fatigue. That's what lingered on. Yeah, so I answered your question.
Good on you, Toddy. Now, don't miss I'm a Celeb. Get Me Out of Here tonight at 7:30 on 10 and 10 Play On Demand. Toddy, it was such a pleasure to speak to you. Absolutely loved you on the show, and now I loved you on our show too. You've been great.
Oh, thank you. Thank you for having me. It's been such fun talking to you, and thanks for all the questions that have come in. I really appreciate that.
No worries. Now, in order for us to go to the commercial break, if you can just count these 5,000 cow's eyes and eat a scorpion, then you'd be able to leave. Never.
Yeah, that was pretty, wasn't it?
Better than eating them, I suppose.